Let's take a look at whether sublimation is endothermic or exothermic. So when we think about an endothermic process or an endothermic reaction, that's going to take in energy. Exothermic, that's going to give it off. So what about sublimation? Is it endothermic or exothermic? So for sublimation, that's when we have a substance that's changing directly from a solid to a gas. There's no liquid phase, and it's a physical process. So you can see here, I've put iodine crystals in a beaker with sand, and I'm heating it up. That purple gas, that's the iodine gas being sublimed. It's changing from the solid to the gas. There's no liquid phase. Since we had to put energy in to make that sand hot and then make the iodine hot, sublimation, it's an endothermic reaction. Remember that endothermic reactions, they take in energy. So that hot plate there that's making the sand hot, then making the iodine hot so it sublimes, we're putting in energy to make that sublimation take place. Think of it this way. We have that iodine solid, and we need to break those molecules apart. They're attracted by intermolecular forces. We put in heat, we can break them apart, and we have iodine gas. The reverse of sublimation, that's called deposition. That's where we have the substance change directly from the gas back to the solid. And again, there's no liquid phase. So we want to know if deposition is exothermic or endothermic. Really, since it's the opposite of sublimation, we know it's going to be exothermic. It's going to give off heat. And you can see I have that watch glass there, and crystals of iodine have formed from the gas. They've changed from the gas directly to those solid crystals. And when they did, they actually gave off heat. It was an exothermic process. That glass got a little bit warmer as we had those crystals of iodine form from the gas. So deposition, that's exothermic because it gives off energy. This is Dr. B talking about sublimation and deposition, whether they are endothermic or exothermic processes. Thanks for watching.